Hey guys, Dr. Wade here. Today I'm going to make my favorite slow carb meal. It's fast, easy to make, and it's good. It's just awesome. I mean, even my kids love it, so it's a wonderful thing, a wonderful way to drop a good 15 pounds in a good 30 to 45 days, somewhere in there. It worked for me, and it's worked for many others, so this is how it works. So I'm basically dicing up. I got onions going there. I did a white onion today. I just diced it up. Put a little grapeseed oil in there, sauteing it, put a little small amount of Kerrygold butter. That's this stuff right here, okay? Natural butter's awesome. It says pure Irish butter, and it is very pure. Next, I'm going to toss in some grass-fed beef. It says organic pasture-raised ground beef here, 85-15. Not a big thing on low-fat, just regular stuff. Okay, so basically I have one onion, chopped it up, then I have 1 pound of organic grass-fed beef. I don't care if it's organic or not, just grass-fed, because you get that CLA, the conjugated linoleic or linoleic acid, which is just known for dropping pounds, especially belly fat. It's awesome. So there's a big difference between just beef that you buy from, you know, the store versus the grass-fed beef, big time. In fact, the number one recognized food for getting rid of belly fat is grass-fed beef. And I can't forget, I do use a little dash when sauteing the onion of Tony's. Can't go wrong with Tony's. And also, as soon as I put the meat in, I put a little dash of this over the meat as well, okay? And I'll try to show this. What you want to do is really chop it up really good. You want to get all of the onions that the flavors just started to come out, really burst out. You want to stir that meat up in there as it browns with the onion there. So, okay. There we go. Oh, and if you can't get grass-fed beef, I get mine ordered from U.S. Wellness Meats right here. I have a link below where you can go right there and get a great deal on the best grass-fed beef I can find. Tastes great, easy to prepare, comes in these little 1 pound packets, it's super good. Okay, next as it browns, I'm getting my frozen chopped spinach. I love frozen vegetables, those are the best. They retain nutrition very well. So I like getting frozen spinach. Can't go wrong with spinach, look it up. It's one of the best superfoods you can get. So I'm going to dump a good bit of this in there. Depends on how mushy you want this to be. I like a fairly good texture. I don't like it to be just completely mushy. So, and that's my word of the week, mushy. And so anyway, I'm getting ready to put this in there. And then I'm going to add some sauerkraut toward the end. And then, of course, I'll have some beans going in just a minute. We'll talk about that. But get your frozen spinach ready. One thing I like about this meal is that, again, it's really kid-friendly. There's a lot of options. You can do the meat and beans separate, and the spinach separate, and have, or you can just mix it all together, which is what I'm going to do because I like to go for convenience and just, you know, the leftovers, you put it in Tupperware and put it in the refrigerator. You get up the next day, it's great breakfast, great lunch. It's makes it fast and easy. So, okay, to strain or not to strain. So here we go. Got a good bit in there. And again, it depends on how much of that fat you want in there. Now, fat is not necessarily bad for you. And this is a good meat. It's a good fat. So it's really the juice quality. How much do you want? So I'm going to strain just a little bit. I'm going to fast strain. I'm going to strain it kind of fast. I'm not going to let it sit there and drip all out. I want to retain some of that, okay? And then I'm going to add my favorite pinto bean, Lux pinto bean. So you can either strain, clean those off really good, or just dump them right in. Again, Lux comes with a lot of, make sure I'm getting that good there. Yeah, left-handed. Lux comes with a real clean mix there. The ingredient listing is good. And basically it's pinto beans, a little salt, water, and some pork in there. But if you're still stuck in the 1970s and you're counting calories, it's the same as anything else. It doesn't have any of the junk. It's just pinto beans, water, and stuff, okay? Not any of the preservatives, no. And it really avoids the nightshades if you're nightshade sensitive. By the way, you can use salsa in this mix, and it is fantastic. Salsa you can use when during the browning meat process or afterward, and it flavors it up so good. But I, you know, like many others, have a nightshade sensitivity, and I don't like inflammation, so I'll leave it off, and most of the time. But sometimes I'll mix it up. About once a week, I'll use salsa. My wife, my kids really love it in there. Flavors up that meat great, and I use a half onion then. Hey, now I just added the chopped spinach frozen directly from the bag. I'm going to stir it up in there. You can also microwave it a little bit to go ahead and loosen it. Again, I'm about convenience, so I just put it right in. I'm about to stir it up. So, here we go. Okay, so I've got it stirred in there really good, chopped up real well. It's already chopped spinach, so there's not a lot of chopping to do. So, let's talk a minute about the importance of the beans when you're doing a slow carb approach. You're not eating any sugar, anything that could be white, in rich white flour, sugar, things like that, white rice, white potatoes. You're leaving all that off. So beans are your kind of how you carry that calorie load during the day. So when you find if you find yourself getting hungry because you're eating a lot of lean meats and vegetables, then you don't have enough beans. So adding the beans is essential. And so there you go. Got to have the beans in there. I don't eat beans every day with it, and I don't eat ground beef every day. But I using the slow carb approach has been fantastic. Like earlier today, I did a salad bar, and I had grilled chicken. I used oil and vinegar mix with broccoli, hummus, which you know was a really good hummus. I just made and I made this. I had a few sunflower seeds in there. Had a let's see. Some pieces of ham. Man, I just made this awesome dish, and it was great. And I didn't get hungry at all. So by the time I got home, I'm you know now cooking this, and I'm gonna put some beans in for that tonight. I'm gonna eat it again tomorrow. So working out really good so far. Hang on, we're gonna do just a little more. We're almost done. Now for the sauerkraut, our fermented food, one of the four missing food groups from my diet, if you will. So, or not really food groups, but cuisines. There's technically, what, four world cuisines, you know, meat off the bone, gut material, let's see, fermented foods is one of them. Okay, so anyway, hey, this is some good human eating here. So basically, I'm just going to get a nice big serving spoonful and just put it in there. I'm going to let it strain out a little bit. So here we go. You can see about how much I have in there, and then I'll stir that in. Okay, so now we have all the mix in, and you can see what it looks like there. Looking good so far. I'm going to let some of the juices cook out of it, cook it down a little bit, as some people say. And then we're going to do the taste test with my daughter to see if it's kid-friendly. And so if she likes it like that, then great. She's 12, right, Claire? Yep. And if she doesn't, well, we add cheese to it. Can't go wrong with that, right? All right, here we go, the ultimate test here. I like it. Now it's time. Let's see, blow that. Hold it. You blow it. Hold it. Okay. Okay, here we go. She's gonna try it. We'll tell them.
It's good.
What do you think? Is it good?
Yeah.
All right. How old are you?
12.
Mm-hmm. You like junk food, right?
Yeah.
But Dad being a doctor of physical therapy, sometimes he just doesn't let you eat all that stuff, does he? So this is kind of a treat, isn't it?
Yeah.
All right. All right. So I turned it down to low. Whoops. Turned it down to low now. And basically, total preparation time is around, let's see, I'm thinking, yeah, it's probably around 13, 15 minutes at the most when I'm moving slow like this. I didn't get all my ingredients out first. I just kind of came in and started cooking, right? I decided to do a quick video to show you that it is real convenient. And again, dropping serious pounds when you do this and never getting hungry. I love this. You don't have to count calories. You can eat as much of this as you want. Great stuff, guys. So enjoy. Oh, wait, one other caveat here. My wife puts cottage cheese on it, and that is allowed in this. So she loves cottage cheese. She puts a little bit on there. It's great. You can also use salsa. Are you going to use salsa on yours? Or are you just going to eat it like that?
I don't know.
Oh, okay. Aha. She did the cheese. And that's just for the kids, not for you. And last thing, remember, if you do this for 5 days straight, you know, stay on a slow carb approach, check out Timothy Ferris's book, The 4-Hour Body. And look at that chapter. It's about page 70, 72, somewhere around in there. Look for a slow carb diet. Do it. Stay on that for a good 5 weeks. 5 days. And on Saturday, I pick Saturday. One day in that week, you can just eat anything you want as much as you want. You can have a great time. Okay, this is Dr. Wade. Oh, and comment below. And if you're doing this, share with me what exactly you've been doing on your Saturdays or your one big cheat day, right? Share it. Okay, take care.